Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Woo, look at DJ Holy Ghost. Give us something to start with this morning.
DJ Holy Ghost.
You thought I was worth dying for. When I wasn't worth you dying for.
Come on now.
Amen.
Come
amen.
On now.
Amen. We start preaching already. Amen. Amen. Y'all ready for some church?
Y'all ready for some church? I'm ready for some church.
Huh? Oh, the one that Easter eggs yesterday, I thought it was like candy, so I like broke it, but it was the confetti one.
Oh, yeah. Went everywhere, didn't it? Amen. Well, welcome family to the Now Church California. It is 10 a.m. We start on time so we can what? End on time. I want you out there to invite somebody to Resurrection Sunday here at the Now Church California. Plug it, tag it, tell somebody, let's come together and worship the Lord. It's a very, very important day because we're going to talk about what he did, but we're going to talk about what he won't do again. And then we're going to talk about what are we going to do today so we become the resurrection of Christ. Amen. Come on, prophet and prophetess. Amen. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. So we got some we have some surprise praise and worship singers today. First and foremost, we don't own the rights to this music, but we're going to have Kirk Franklin come before us. And then we're going to come on up here, prophet. And then we're going to let the Lord lead us from there. Amen. Come on, stand to your feet and let's worship the Lord today. Because it's only one God. It's only one God like you. Hey.
How y'all doing this evening?
You know, he said, bounce.
How y'all doing
bounce,
this evening?
Bounce.
Do y'all want that bounce?
Do you want that bounce? Come on.
I said,
do you want that bounce? That bounce? That bounce? Hey. Come on, say it. Everybody wanna be like you, man. Sell power and praise like you, man. See, there is no God, there's one God. There's no one like you.
Who gave their life like you, and who paid our price?
Come on, say it.
There's only
one God. See, there's no one like you.
First, who can touch like you?
Come on, praise
or heal us like you do.
You do.
We stumble and we stray.
Come on.
Where you are.
Come on, everybody praise him.
pick a name. Because he's worthy. Tony, go help her. Go help her.
Made. I will rejoice and be glad in it. I don't need you to motivate me. I don't need you to push me. I know what he did for me, and I know that I deserve to give him my best. It's my responsibility to give God my best. It's your responsibility to give God your best. You know why? Because he is the best, and he did the best thing that he ever could have did for me. He saved this old drug head, this old... I don't want to call on them names, but you know, the man that I used to be, he resurrected me. And we're not here to celebrate what has been done. We're here today to celebrate what we're doing now. He won't. See, the whole subject of this service today is a one-time deal. It was only a one-time sacrifice to come to earth. It was only a one-time deal to be persecuted and beat and treated the way he was. It was only a one-time deal that he hung on that cross for me. And it was only a one-time deal that he went to hell and broke the veil of this old covenant. And it was only a one-time deal that he ascended. Yeah. What am I going to do now? Right. In my resurrection, what are you going to do in your resurrection? Amen? All right. Amen, amen, amen. Hallelujah. Lord, put this song on my heart this morning. We're just going to try it. It says, Lord, I lift your name on high. Lord, I lift your name on high. Lord, I love to sing your praises. I'm so glad you're in my life.
so glad you came to save us.
Keep here, pass this out.
The earth to the ground.
Okay, we're gonna bring in another praise and worship leader. Welcome in, Pastor Donnie McClurkin. Come on. Welcome in, Pastor Donnie McClurkin. Come on, just lift your hands and let's praise him today. Everybody was looking for Donnie to walk in.
Simple song, you know it. It just says,
come on, say it.
Lord, I lift your name on high.
Oh, yeah, you know.
Come on, just lift your hands and worship him.
I'm so glad you're in my life. Oh, my
I'm so glad you came to save us. This is my favorite part, Apostle.
Lord, I lift your name on high.
Come on and sing it with me this morning.
Lord, I love to sing your praises. I'm so glad you're in my life.
I'm so very glad you came.
I'm so glad you came to save.
Come on, sing it.
You came from heaven to earth to show the way.
Come on, just worship.
From the cross cross to the grave, from the grave to the sky. Lord, I lift your name on high. 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 Come on, worship him right now. Hallelujah. Come on, in your own way, in your own method, in whatever it is that you get out of yourself, I dare you just to give him your best praise right now. You ain't got to make a sound. You just got to deliver to him your best praise, your best worship, and your best thank you ever in this world. Thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Lord, I lift your name on high. You came from heaven to earth to show the way, from the earth to the cross, my debt to pay, from the cross to the grave, from the grave to the sky. Lord, I lift your name on high. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Is he worthy today? Is he worthy today? Did we come here intentionally to give him what he deserves? Our best. Because he does such a great thing for us. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. Oh, I thank you, Lord. You're holy. You're worthy. You're faithful. And you are God. Hallelujah. Oh, come on, just praise with me this morning. You are holy.
Praise him. What a privilege
I can search the heavens high. I can search the earth below, but there's no one, no one, no one, no one like you, Jesus.
This opportunity to praise you, this opportunity to give you honor and glory, which you deserve. As we enter into the next phase of our service, we had some now worship. Now we're going to come and have a now prayer. Then we're going to have some now giving.
Yes.
Then we're going to have some now resurrection meal. And then we're going to have a now resurrection word. Amen. Amen. I'm going to ask Prophet to come and pray for us. And if he can just lead us into an offering after that, Minister Martinet will come and read the scripture. Then we're going to have Prophet come back. I love the, you remember the last first Sunday he was here? He broke it down so dynamic.
Yeah.
On what communion really means. Amen. We're going to have him come back after she reads the scripture. And then he'll give us a little exhortation. And then we're going to have communion. And then we're going to have some word, and then we're going to have brunch. Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. Praise the Lord, people of God. Amen. Let's all pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, God, we bless you. We praise you. We magnify you. We declare that this is a significant day.
Yes, Lord.
It is a day that we celebrate.
Yes, Lord.
not just your rising, but our rising.
Oh, yes.
Because we were with you through the whole process. Mm. When you died, we died.
Yeah.
When you were raised, we were raised with you.
Yes, Lord.
And so we bless you now. And we thank you now that this revelation now is embedded in the hearts of every individual, every believer right now. In the name of Jesus, I thank you that because of the resurrection of Jesus, there's power, there's presence, there's purpose that's now released in the hearts of your people. God, I thank you right now that God, as we grasp the understanding of what you actually did for us, God, we declare now that there's a disclosure in our own mind of who we are because of what you did.
Yes, Lord.
And we will ever be grateful.
Yes.
We will be ever to give you glory and glory. Honor and praise and worship. Not just because of what we say, but because of what we do. We show it through our life. We show it through our offering. We show it through our gratitude. And we show it how we treat one another. God, thank you for your love, for it was your love that caused you to go to that cross. Oh, hallelujah. We are blessed to know that.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you for your faithfulness. Thank you for being so good to us. God, you, even though in and of our own selves, we don't deserve it, but you made us worthy.
Hey.
You made us worthy because of your shed blood. Thank you for your
thank
goodness.
You.
We vow to give you glory and honor and praise.
Glory.
And all God's people said amen and amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 Hallelujah.
Glory.
You come.
Glory.
Glory. Glory.
Amen. Be your man, you God.
We on the
beat.
God bless you. How's everybody doing?
Great.
If God's been good to you, make some noise, please.
Yes.
If you know that God has delivered you from some things and made a way out of no way, and he's still holding on to you, because he loves you. He loves us all individually.
Time we just
equal.
Give thanks. For the newness.
Let's go.
Praise him.
I love you, Lord.
He
loves you. He loves you, you see. He loves you. Hey.
Yeah.
Thank you, Lord. We want to give you all the honor and praise on today. This is your day, Lord.
Come on.
The only reason we have things is because of you, Lord. Thank you for making me new, Father. Covered by the blood of Christ. Every day I sacrifice. Ever since I got saved, it's like I live another life. You don't focus and I want this. It's guaranteed that I won't miss. I am a king and I am a dream, and that is why I've been chosen.
Hey.
I am a sinner repenting for all the sin that I've committed, and no, I'm not worthy. You do not deserve to be here. You know my pain. You know my story. I am a vessel. Use me for your glory. You told me to never ever worry. As long as I protect my glory. Sprinkle me with holy water. I do this for my only daughter. Guide myself, deny my flesh. Please use me in that order. I don't want to live if I can't live for you. And you know this. I was broken and hopeless.
Hey.
In the midst of adversity, you gave me the gift of diversity. When everybody seemed the worst in me, you picked me up and lift the curse from me. Now I gotta put you first, gotta do my work. I just wanna be the one that everybody wanna come to for learning you. Thank you, Lord. We thank you for this day, Father. We thank you for this opportunity. We thank you for doors open and doors closed, Father. We thank you for new friendships, new relationships. Thank you, Father God. Thank you for the breath. Thank you for my clothes. Thank you for my family. Thank you for my ministry. Thank you for my pastor. Thank you for all of your children, Lord.
Thank you, news, Father.
Testimony come from tests.
Yes.
Resurrect and resurrect.
Yes.
Immaculate mental conception. I follow your steps.
Yes.
Though I'm in this world, I am not of it. I'm a set apart like a set up. So please do not judge me. I'm true to your word. I'm doing your work. My faith is decreasing every day. It feels like I'm moving your earth. I just want to get back to my community and make this a better place for you and me. I just want to bring the Bloods and Crips together so we can make peace and unity.
Hey.
Now who's coming with me?
I'm with you.
When I'm gone, will you miss me? water right now, y'all. In the name of Jesus. In the name of the Almighty. Because he can do it and he will do it. You just have to obey. You just have to obey.
Y'all get ready for a now word. It's going down in the now church of California, everybody.
Hey!
I'm your brother Yukon, and I love you, but God loves you more. Thank you, Pastor E.
Come on, put your hands together for Jesus in this place. Thank you for making me new, Father.
We got our engineer. We got the studio. We got the artist. We got the remix coming. Live at you. Thank you for making me new, Father.
Hey, you gonna get on it too, prophetess.
Come on, Marnette. Yes, we gonna have a now church remake. Amen. I want to say this to somebody out there that you might think your song is old, that it ain't got recorded yet. Do not give up on your dream. Your song still has relevance in this world. Somebody needs to hear what you gotta say.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Good morning. Good morning. Happy Resurrection Sunday, y'all. Happy Resurrection Sunday. Glory to God. Thank you for making me new, Father. Woo! Thank you for making me new this morning. I'm coming to you this morning from 1 Corinthians 11, verse 23-33. For I received the Lord what I also passed on to you. The Lord Jesus, on the night he was betrayed, he took bread. And when he gave thanks, he broke it and said, "This is my body, which is for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way, after supper, he took the cup, saying, "This cup is a new covenant in my blood. Do this whenever you drink it in remembrance of me. For whenever you eat this bread and drink this cup, you proclaim the Lord's death until he comes. Therefore, whoever eats the bread or drinks the cup of the Lord in an unworthy manner will be guilty of sinning against the body and blood of the Lord. A man ought to examine himself before he eats of the bread and drinks of the cup, before anyone who eats or drinks without recognizing the body of the Lord eats or drinks judgment on himself. That is why many among you are weak and sick, and a number of you have fallen asleep. But if we judged ourselves, if we would not come under judgment, when we are judged by the Lord, we are being disciplined so that we will not be condemned with the world. So then, my brothers, when you come together to eat, wait for each other. If anyone is hungry, he should eat at home, so that when he eat together, it may not result in judgment. And when I come, I will give you further directions." And this is the word of the Lord. Praise
amen.
Be to God.
Amen.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for making me new, Father.
Thank you. Right there. Okay.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Lord.
Praise the Lord, people of God.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah.
Oh, my goodness. I love this part of the service. Because, listen, we don't do this because of tradition. No, y'all better hear what I just said. We don't do this by tradition. We do it by revelation. Everybody say revelation.
Revelation.
The word revelation means apocalypse. Means something is unveiled. Something is disclosed. Something is being disclosed to you right now. And listen, I've been ministering a powerful series, and I just want to share briefly on it, called Four Provisions in the Blood. Because see, one of the things you got to understand, people of God, there's power in the blood. And one of the things we got to get back to preaching is about the blood. Amen. With all this vaccine and stuff going on, listen, I've already been vaccinated. It's called the blood of Jesus. Now, come on. Y'all didn't hear what I just said. I've already been vaccinated. It's called the blood of Jesus. Amen. His blood is running through me and it keeps my immune system strong. Come on now. Hallelujah. So listen, I'm going to share four things real quickly that the body did and the blood did. Amen. Listen, when his body was not broken. The Bible is very clear. His body was given. Amen. Because the Bible said when he was on the cross, not one of his bones was broken. So listen, that means that guess what? You and I can have fellowship with him because of what he did. Amen. And so right now, come on, lift up the hand. Say, Father, in the name of Jesus, I receive the benefit of your body. Oh no, you missed what I said. There's benefit in the body. Amen. And guess what? There's benefits in the body because what he did with his body, we can come together as a body. Oh, come on now. Revelation flowing now. Because of what he did in his body, we can come together as the body because we are the body of Christ. Amen. Amen. And so, Father, we receive the benefits of the body. And God, we declare now that, Father, as we come together in the name of Jesus, there is fresh revelation of what you did in your death, your burial, your resurrection, your ascension, and your seating. In the name of Jesus, we thank you and we believe we receive it. All God's people said, amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you. Thank you. I want you to meditate on that right now. Hallelujah. The Bible said after he took the cup. Now, I want to share these four things concerning the blood. In Exodus chapter 12, verse 13, everybody say, the blood provided protection. It provided protection. I want to let you know because of the blood, there is protection. Amen. Number two, the blood provides deliverance. Come on, everybody say, the blood provides deliverance. That's Galatians chapter 4 verse 3 through 5 and Hebrews chapter 9 verse 22. Number 3, the blood provides a new beginning. Oh, come on now. The Bible says, if any man be in Christ, he is a new creation. Old things are passed away. Behold, all things are new. There is a new beginning. Amen. This is your beginning of month. This is your new year. This is, amen. You don't have to wait till the first of the month to say Happy New Year. Every day when you rise up, you can say Happy New Year. Why? Because it's a new beginning. It's a new month. It's a new day. Amen. Hallelujah. And last of all, the blood provides a witness. Everybody say the blood provides a witness.
The blood provides a witness.
See, people, what you don't understand is that when the blood was sprinkled, the Bible says it was sprinkled on the mercy seat. And because the blood was sprinkled, it speaks from that place.
Yes.
No, you better hear what I just said. The blood has a voice. I said the blood has a voice, which means if the Bible says his mercies are new every morning and the blood is bringing mercy, that means, guess what? You got to agree with the blood. Whatever the blood says, you got to say. The blood says you're healed, you better say you're healed. The blood says you're delivered, you better say you're delivered. Amen. Whatever the blood says, you got to agree with it. Amen. The blood says his mercies are new every morning. Every morning when you get up, guess what? There's new mercy. So guess what? I'm in agreement with the blood. Why? Because the Bible says, let your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. So we got to agree with the blood. Let's all lift the blood. Father, in the name of Jesus, we agree with the blood. We know that Abel's blood spoke of vengeance, but your blood speaks mercy. And so, Father, we thank you for the blood. You said without the shedding of blood, there is no remission of sin. Not listen, people of God. Notice what the Bible says. It doesn't say the forgiveness of sin. The forgiveness of sin has to do with atonement.
Yes.
That word atonement means to cover. But the remission of sins means eradication.
Yes.
the removing. In other words, there's no trace of your sins. See, the enemy comes to remind you of what's no longer there. Oh, come on, people of God. You better catch the revelation. There is no trace of your sin. It has been put away. It has been remitted. Amen. And so, Father, we declare that our sins have been remitted. There's no trace of it, Father. And so, God, we thank you that today we have a new consciousness that our sin has been dealt away with. And we receive the benefit of the blood. And all God's people said amen and amen. Amen. Let's all drink.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Now open up your mouth and give God praise. No, come on. You can do better than that. You can do better than that.
I know it was the blood.
Hallelujah.
And I know it was the blood for me. One day when I was lost, he died upon the cross. And I know it was the blood for me. And I know it was the blood. And I know it was the blood. And I know it was the blood for me. One day when I was lost, he died upon the cross. And I know it was the blood for me.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Amen, amen, amen. Thank you, my brother. You bless me every time. Anytime you speak, you bless me. But about that, you ought to teach a class on communion. And you got some knowledge in that. And I get blessed every time. I mean, I hope everybody else did too. Amen?
Amen.
Is God good? Is God good?
Yes.
See, something, you know, that I have to always remind myself is that we all got to believe in something.
Come on. Ain't no atheist.
But I always try to see if you believe in something, does it make you believe in yourself?
My God.
Because a lot of people try to say believe in this, but don't believe in yourself. Believe in me. Instead of knowing that if you believe in something, it has to encourage you to believe in yourself.
Amen.
I welcome everybody today. I'm grateful today that God has sent each and every one of you. It's not a mistake that you're here. It's not just an invitation. It's because God called you to be here for such a time as this. Amen.
That's right. Amen.
And for whatever reason you leave here, you're going to leave here different than you came.
That's right.
Change, rearrange, and transform by the renewing of your mind because of the word of God.
Yes.
So we're talking about resurrection.
That's right. Come on.
Sunday. The day that most churches are talking about, he got up.
Come on.
That most churches are talking about, he got hung, he got persecuted, he got killed, he rolled away the stone. Somebody, right now I felt it in the spirit, somebody preaching about the stone rolling away.
Okay.
I feel over in this other church, they're talking about him still on the cross.
Okay.
Talking about forgive them, for they know not what they do. I know there's some churches over there preaching about him still being in the grave. But over here, we want to tell you that what has been done has been done.
It's done. It's finished.
The topic of this message and this service, every resurrection, is called a one-time deal.
Oh, come on.
He won't come from heaven for my sins ever again.
Come on.
He won't die for my sins again. He won't get buried for my sins.
Right.
He won't get up for my sins. And he won't ascend back to the right hand because he's at the right hand of the Father. Colossians chapter 3 says, he says, seek those things which are above, not what on earth, where Jesus, what's his name? Jesus is sitting at the right hand of the Father. So why would I want to talk about his death, his burial, or his resurrection? I believe in his life. I don't believe in what he did. I believe in what's been done. So you got to know that God has already fixed and purposed your life. The Bible says he knew you before the foundation of the world. The Bible even says he predestined. He called your name. Put your name on it. See, what God has done for you has already been done. But when I look at a one-time deal, that's what he did. But that does not alleviate me from a daily deal.
That's it, that's it,
See, I got to learn that the Bible says in Luke 9 and 23 says, if you desire to come after me, first you got to deny yourself. Then you got to take up your own cross. Then follow him. See, going after Christ means you got to let yourself die so he can live. And then once you die, now you got to get on your mission. Ooh. You got to get on your mission, not my mission. Because what God has for me is for me. What God has for you is for you. You got to get on your mission to what? Follow him. Following Christ is not as easy as you think it is. It's not a one-time deal. No, it's a lifetime deal. See, God has the ability to do something once and it's done. No, we have to continue to repetition. We have to make it easy. We got to do it where it's a pleasure. We got to do it often that we develop a habit. I don't care what you believe in. You better get a good habit. Come on. If you don't have a good habit, you won't have a good life.
Oh, my God.
So I was asking the Lord, what you want me to, because I preach one-time deal every year, but it's always a different word that comes along with it.
Yeah.
And this morning, he said, I want you to go to John chapter 11. I don't know if you remember chapter 11. They had sent for Jesus because Lazarus was sick. No, remember, he was sick at first. He was sick and shut in at first. And then the second thing, he was dead. And they called for him. And they knew that Jesus and Lazarus were homies. They were good friends. They imagined he was going to drop everything and come. He took his time. Oh, Jesus. Hey, he took his time. Verse 23 says, Jesus said to her, your brother will rise again. Now watch this. The word will is a promise. If God says you will be blessed, if you follow his command, you will be blessed. But he also says, if you don't, you will be cursed. See, there's no middle ground, you kind. That's either you're blessed or you're cursed. You're either blessed or you're cursed. There's no, I'm riding the fence. I'm straddling the road. No, you're either blessed or cursed. But he said he will rise again. That means he was already risen. Again means a repeat.
That's right.
Again means he had to do it over. He says, watch. He said, oh my God. He says, Jesus said to her, your brother will rise again. Martha said to him, I know that he will rise again in the resurrection at the last day. No. Jesus said to her, he says, I am the resurrection of life. He who believes in me, though he may die, he shall what? Live. And whoever lives and believes in me shall never die. Do you believe this? See, in your resurrection, you got to believe some things. Apostle, prophet, I just missed the fivefold today. See, in your resurrection, you got to believe not just only in something, you got to believe in yourself. I can tell you how great you are all day long, but until you start telling yourself you're great, until you tell yourself that you're healed, until you start telling yourself that you're delivered, you'll never be delivered. He says, I am the resurrection of life. So you ain't got to worry about this physical body because this physical body going to die one day.
Yeah.
Don't get it twisted. This will come back from which it came.
Yeah.
Oh, but this spirit that's in me that believes. Yeah. See, your flesh don't believe. Your flesh obeys.
Yeah. Yeah.
I'm going to say that again. Your flesh does not believe. Your flesh obeys.
Oh.
It's either going to do what you say or what you say not to do. It's not going to go against you because you have all control. He says, I am the resurrection and life. Only thing he asked you to do was to believe. That's all, just to believe. Now some people say, I got faith. You cannot have faith if you don't believe. Because then he would have said, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son that whoever had faith. But he said, whoever believes will not perish, but have what? Everlasting life. But you say that might be a little bit contradictory. You just said flesh will die. Your flesh will, but your spirit will live.
The Bible says God is spirit, and those who worship him must worship in spirit and in truth. You got to know him spiritually before you can ever know him truthfully. If you don't have a personal relationship with the resurrection of life, then you're dead. Because you don't believe. Oh, I go to church, pastor. That don't mean you believe. Oh, I pay my tithes once a month. That don't mean you believe. I come to the Easter basket. That don't mean you believe. If you believe, he says you will do what I told you to do. See, when I get resurrected, I get some get right in me. When I get resurrected, I get some get right because I know how to tell me no. See, the favorite word I have in my vocabulary is N-O. And I'll tell you no first because I tell myself no first. A lot of times I got trouble just by saying, yeah, maybe, okay. No, if I would have said no, I would have never went to prison. If I would have said no, I never would have been on dope. If I would have said no, I wouldn't have children all over this country. If I would have said no. Can I tell the truth? If I just would have said no, I'm not getting in that car because I know you got a truck full of dope. Maybe I'm the only one that got caught up like that. You want to get in that Benz, how that beat. I'm going to ride down the street. Man, he got a new car. You know he got dope in the trunk. When they pull you over, you be like, man, why you didn't? All I had to do was say no. No to the world. And yes to the resurrection of life. Flip over to 12:25. I'm on the 25s today. Woo, my Jesus. 23. We'll start at 23. 23, 23, 23. John 12:23. It says, but Jesus answered them, saying, the hour has come that the Son of Man should be glorified. Most assuredly, I say to you, unless a grain of wheat falls into the ground and dies, it remains alone. But if it dies, it produces what? Much fruit. He who loves his life will lose it, and he who hates his life in this world will keep it for eternal life. But verse 26, if anyone serves me, let him follow me. And where I am, there my servant will be also. If anyone serves me, him my Father will honor. See, you got to know something. In your resurrection, it's just a following act. You ain't got to watch me. Don't watch me because I'll probably lead you wrong. Okay. Don't follow me because we'll probably go down the wrong street. Don't get in my car because I might be the one to get you in trouble. But if you learn to follow Christ, you know that you now know that what he did for you was to show you what you can do for somebody else. If you know in your resurrection that if you follow him, if you now deny yourself, and if you take up your cross daily, how many? Daily. See, some of y'all want a one-time cross deal when you need a daily deal.
Oh, my God.
Right. Mm.
Says, I am the resurrection of life. That your life can be reborn today. Mm. I want to say this to you in all honesty. I had a little hoop to go today. I was just the first time on this anointed podium. I blessed my family for blessing this, but guess what? God said, no, settle down. Somebody needs to hear a really prevalent word today that you won't just be here for the service, but you'll be here for the service. See, when you follow God, you learn to serve. You learn to serve first God, then you learn to serve yourself. Then you learn to serve your brother because he says, love your neighbor as you what? Love yourself. I want to say to you today in closing that this is your season for grace. This is your season for mercy. This is your season for change. So in this season, I decree and declare to you right now to throw it in the altar. Whatever it is you came here with, we all came here with something. Even me, I came here with something this morning. Backache, get off me. Shoulder pain, get off me right now. Get off me right now. Past discretions, get off me right now. Old sins, get off me right now. I was talking to my brother this morning. I done did some bad things in my life. But God doesn't look at the bad things you did. He looks at the good things you're doing right now. Because the apostle told you this morning, he says that your sins have already been washed away. Why am I still sinful when my sins have been washed away? Because I haven't been washed. So I decree and declare over you today in this message that God has removed that burden off your back, has removed that burden off your shoulder, has removed that burden off the top of your head, has removed that burden out of your head, has removed that burden in here, has removed that burden right up here, has removed that burden right over here. You know, it's been kind of hurting you a little bit. Thought you had a crook in the neck. It's gone in the name of Jesus. Now somebody say, how do you know that? I don't know. I'm just a messenger.
Okay.
And when God says, say it, I say it. And believe me, it's truthful. Because I believe in God. Heavenly Father God, we thank you today for everyone that's here. We thank you, Lord, that we've all received a nugget of knowledge that we will leave this place different than we came. We thank you, Lord, that as we serve you, Lord, that we'll go forward and serve someone else. We thank you that as we serve you, Lord, we'll learn to be more careful, to be more kind, and more considerate of one another. We thank you today for your sacrifice, but now we thank you for our sacrifice, that we will die, that we will get up, and that we will be ascended in the right place at the right time to do what you called us to do, that's to tell somebody about your goodness. We thank you. We praise you. We glorify you in the name that is above every name. And the church said,
amen.
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 Yeah.
Amen. Now, you know, I told you this is an hour service. And I don't like preaching long no way because I lose you. My daddy taught me that a long time ago. He said, son, he said, see all up there? He said, but you just lost three. And he said, when you run over here and you do this one, then you lost five more. He said, when you run over here and you do this, you done got all your offering and left out the church. You got to keep it real. Amen. So we're going to transition. We're going to stay in service because we have brunch prepared for you guys. And we're going to close out with this song. Yeah. I want to be like that. I want to be like Paul.
I want to be like Paul. Hey.
I just want to serve you.
When I'm serving, that means I'm giving you the best I can.
I just want to serve you.
I'm doing everything
for
myself.
Forever, I'm going to need your help. I done came a long way. I done did a lot of dirt. You can say I'm a survivor. I am here to give the church. I'm just trying to fill his purpose. I'm just trying to make it work. I'm just happy to be forgiven and forgive those who I've hurt. Lord, only you know what I go through when I'm all by myself. I can do this by myself. No, forever I'ma need your help. Forever I'ma be in service. Tell my story just to let you know I worship you before anyone on this earth. I'm committed to you first. We are the body of Christ. He is the one sacrificed. He is the one who can lead you to freedom. Will never mislead you the way into life. Revelations. I am the soul of a nation. I am my own motivation. Dynasty gold is my baby. We sitting with Jesus. Finna eat with the believers. Everyone we've been sowing for seasons. It is our time and here's the reason.
Reason, yeah.
Father, we need you.
Hey.
Your love is everything I want.
Hey.
It's every dude and I'm on it. I promise you'll get the
I just want to serve you.
Praise God. Hallelujah. Praise God. Hallelujah.
I just want to serve you.
Praise God, hallelujah. Thank you, Lord, for this life.
I just want to be a better person. Be a better man. Be there for my daughter. Be a family man.
You know what I go through and I am alone.
Oh.
Father, I need you, can't do this alone.
I am a living testimony, walk a miracle. Clinical, spiritual, from the village. I can feel it, can you feel it? This is part of my healing. It's time that we build a bigger building. It's time that we be there for our children.
Hey.
It's time that we teach them how to love and show them how to feel it.
Oh.
See, all of my life,
like,
I've been running from myself.
Self.
Now that I feel Christ,
Christ.
I'm so glad I feel Christ.
Christ
with me when I fail, with me in a cell, with me when everybody wouldn't help. He is the one who brought me back to life. He is the reason for my sacrifice.
Hey.
I am a promise, speaking prophecy. Men on the mission, ain't no stopping
me.
Was given the vision to be whole and possibly change all unconsciously. If you really love and follow me, cause greater He is who's inside of me, and greater you are if you let Him be.
give you praise. Give him glory. Hey, come on.
I just want to serve you.
I love you, Lord.
Come on, somebody.
I love you, Lord.
I just want to serve you.
Have your way, Father. Have your way on today, Father.
I just want to be a better person.
Yeah.
Be a better man.
Yeah.
Be there for my daughter.
Yeah.
Be a family man.
You know what I go through and I am alone. Father, I need you can't do this alone.
Father, I need you can't do this alone.
God bless y'all.
Bless y'all. Bless y'all. Bless y'all. Now we're going to ask you to go that way and get a plate. You are dismissed. Amen. 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 Hallelujah.
Come say the grace, Jeremiah.
Come on, Jeremiah.
Come on, come on, Jeremiah.
Oh no.
Jeremiah, come on, man. Family, family, family.
Come on, man. Pray over the food.
Bless it. Bless it. Come on.
Bless the food.
Resurrection Day, baby.
Father God, thank you for the food we're about to receive from our body. Thank you for the wonderful people that prepared it. Thank you for the glory of today. Thank you for dying on the cross for our sins.
Thank you.
Thank you for all the love. Thank you for the blessings. Thank you for life.
Yes.
In Jesus' name I pray, amen.
Amen. Amen.
Let the church say amen. Let the church say amen. God has spoken. So let the church say amen. Bless you guys.
Yeah, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Love it.
Oh.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you,
Lord.
Get your plate. Make your plate. You good? Okay, you must eat. You going to eat somewhere. All right, where you going? Oh, okay. Yeah. That'll work. What's up, brother? How you doing, man? God bless you, man. It's all right, bro. 10? We look, and I don't be funny, but like, you see that clock? From 10 to 11, I start on time, and then we end on time. I think and they service just starting. Come on, man, we are every. Yeah, man, come on, let me get your card, bro, so we can stay in contact. Now, we having brunch, man. Y'all should come and have some brunch with us, or y'all gonna go to the other side. Okay, there you go. See you Tuesday, Tony. God bless you.
It's the second one.
Good morning. God bless you.
Yeah, you can get what you want. Yeah, go right in. Yeah, you know, yeah. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, I'm sorry, y'all. Wait a minute. Y'all listening to the food. Y'all want something to eat?
I do not
want
to eat.
Okay. What's it?
Laurel and
don't make me name. I know the other gift.
Where's it at?
Amen. All the gifts up in here.
They still, they watching out. Y'all come get y'all plate too, Miss Minister Shannon, Evangelist Virginia.
Okay.
Love you guys.